The Pathare Prabhu community has been one of the earliest settlers of Mumbai. Their food is really spicy and has strong punches of garlic. They love their seafood. And so today I'm going to show you one very simple recipe from the Pathare Prabhu community, the prawn khadkadda. Let's make the Pathare Prabhu sambar masala first. For this I've taken 2 tablespoons wheat, 2 tablespoons split Bengal gram, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon fenugreek seeds, a pinch of asafoetida, a teaspoon of black peppercorns, 20 Kashmiri dry red chilies, 8 tablespoon coriander seeds, 1.5 tablespoon cumin seeds and 1.5 tablespoon mustard seeds. Now besides the turmeric powder and the asafoetida, I'm going to dry roast all these ingredients for about 3 to 4 minutes on a medium flame. The roasting is done. Now let's add the turmeric and the asafoetida. And now we'll cool it and grind this to a fine powder. Our masala is ready. Now let's make the khadkhadla. For that, I've heated a pan and I'm going to add 5 tablespoons of oil. To this oil, I'm going to add a pinch of asafoetida and I'm going to add 1.5 tablespoon of garlic paste. So keep the flame of the gas on a low. Now this garlic paste has to be fried only till the raw smell goes off, but the color shouldn't change. Now I'm going to add 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 teaspoons of Kashmiri chili powder, and 2 teaspoons of the Pathare Prabhu sambar masala that we had made. Now I'm just going to fry this masala. Fry it on a low flame. I'm going to add some salt to this. You need to fry this masala for at least 3 to 4 minutes without changing the color too much. So you have to do this on an absolute low flame. Now let's add the prawns. I've taken 12 prawns here which I've shelled and deveined. Originally, the head of the prawns is not removed. The legs are trimmed and it is deveined. This is done because the head releases good flavors into this curry. But you know, my family doesn't prefer the head. So I'm going to add it without the head. Now I'm going to just coat these prawns well with the masala. And I'm going to add 4 tablespoons of water to this. And I'm going to gently cook these prawns for 4 minutes in this. Don't use the spoon too much now to coat the prawns. Just gently shake the vessel. Prawns don't take a very long time to cook. We have kept these prawns in the gravy for almost 5 minutes and now the prawns are done and our khadkhadla is also ready. This khadkhadla has to be eaten with varan, which is a Maharashtrian dal, hot steamed rice. It's a perfect combination. You saw how easy it was to make this recipe. Instead of prawns, you can also use lobsters for this dish. So please try this recipe at home and let me know.